Yo, what a difference. I mean, last week it was minus 15. Snow, couldn't really do much.
Having fun? How was school?
And this week, I'm in a t-shirt. I mean, I've just done a bit of work and warmed up, but I'm in a t-shirt. Like, I mean, it's gorgeous. Couldn't be any nicer. Sun's out. So we're gonna just carry on with this sycamore and still deciding what thickness to do the planks. I mean, they're gonna be big, so you want them chunky, really. The wider the plank is, as a rule of thumb, the way I feel about it, is have them thicker. So there's a really big plank. It looks silly if you mill it at an inch thick. You know, mill it at 2 or 3 inches, 2.5 inches thick. That's just the way I see it, you know. That's all. Right, stand by.
Got all the thermals on, Blake.
Have you?
Yeah.
Better get them off. Really good tip, these ratchet spanners, you want a couple of these. I don't know where the other one's gone, of course, but ratchet spanner, 13mm, half inch, whatever you're doing, they're basically the same. I suspect these nuts are, yeah, they do feel like half inch. I mean, it's an American mill, yeah, they're baggy on a 13mm, so, you know, but 13 works great. Yeah, we'll get half inch, doesn't really matter. Right, stand by.
So that was a bit of a mission, because when you don't want too much of the chain out one side, it tends to come off the bar and flap around, you get more vibration, so you're trying to even out that difference. You know, ideally you'd be tight on both sides like a bandsaw guide, but yeah, so I'm sort of, I've got to pull it back in, try to push it a bit, and then we're trying to keep it down. That you probably notice the cupping in that. I mean, that's just because it's dried over the weekend, we released the tension. So we're doing one slab, we'll flip it, have a look. If we will then check it with a jig, check if it's flat. If we need to re-mill with the ladder, we'll do that. So that's it now. I've just jigged it up a little bit this side, a little bit this side, and now when you look down it, that is perfectly level to the other sticker, so it's level this way, which is always good. So you can see where
don't know, 10 mil, 12 mil high on here, maybe a fraction more on that one. And we'll just try and straighten it up. And it's a cracking piece of wood, so I want to make the most of it. Right, stand by. That was a bit close. Oh, that was nice then. Just, I put it up against the fence. It's lovely to take a picture with somebody stood by it for scale, you know? Like, really nice. I'll only do it to one board because it's a right faff, you know? Yeah. Anyway, gave me an idea for another video.
So if I did this again,
I would do this tree differently. I should have spotted that was included bark down the centre there. So it's really weak. I mean, the boards are flexing. It's only joined together lower down. If I'd known that, you know, maybe I should have spotted it. But if I'd known it, I would have just cut it in half. I would have cut that there, let it fall into two halves, and then I actually would have milled it this way, and I think I would have got better, you know, not better boards, but they would have been, you know, they're really nice boards because of this rippling here and stuff. And if I'd gone the other way, could have been, you know, could have been, should have been, you know, whatever. But you know, just try and learn. You just got to try and learn. Like, oh yeah, all right, I didn't, you know, could have got that better. But you know, what's to say? What's to say it wouldn't be? This could look lovely with a bit of glass in here. Who knows?